wanna touch your life. I wanna be the change. I'm gonna shine my light. I'm gonna make a difference. Touch your life. Be the change. Shine my light. And make a difference.
Nigeria, and welcome to Airtel Touching Lives, the show that celebrates and assists the individuals and projects that are making a difference to the lives of people around them. My name is Wanawana, and just like Airtel, I have a passion to make a difference and transform lives. I invite you to join us on an emotional journey as we witness some incredibly touching moments. We take you across the country, meeting individuals, families, and communities who are going that extra mile to achieve something for everyone. They're trying to make life better, not just for themselves, but for others around them. Coming up in this episode, we visit a unique computer school that provides free training for youth from disadvantaged backgrounds. And we meet an elderly woman that has been marginalized all of her life because she's barren and unable to bear children. Computer training is a good way to open many doors in life. However, the problem is that most people who could benefit from it cannot afford to pay for it. And that's where Akinwale Adesina comes in and trains youth that are most in need for free. Airtel went to see how we could help him touch more lives.
The computer school is situated on a busy national road. Many people drive through town, but few stop and contribute to local businesses. There is a lot of unemployment, especially amongst the youth. And the town is in need of development. But despite these challenges, some are making a positive change.
4 years ago, I was able to meet Akinwale in a particular computer training that was organized. I nominated Akinwale because he was willing to learn, and it was his first time of actually learning computer, how to use computer. So the trainers were happy to have him around because he's always willing to learn. He's gentle, he's nice, he's kind. He's always willing to help others. Akinwale is one of the hardworking young men that is actually available in this town.
Akinwale
has chosen to train others in that particular area. It's going to empower youth in this community, and it's going to enhance the economy of this community.
You know, my man, the last year, I want my kikere. But do my new, you know, didn't last year, I want balagbana. That is the she, obolo boyinka. But this series, the idea of what should be. Nigba ti awon eyan ni anfani ati ori ofe boya lati ko tabi lati gbianju lati le mo so inu mi ma n do lopolopo gba ti mo ba ri omode to ni ifara enije lati mo nkan papa julo nkan to ro mo iwe so en lo tun ma lo ma ti mi lati ko omode ati agbalagba ni computer yi.
There's always need for computer literacy. Computers are everywhere, and we use it in everyday activity. Without adequate computer literacy, kids and young minds and youth can actually get any job.
Kini iwulo computer, kini ti computer je. Abade wo iwulo computer ni bi ise gan ka bere lati bi awon profession ishewa, banking work, even in church, every places. So computer is being useful. But money is we are mobile share jam loan you, mobile share CBT you, is the computer. So gege bi odo. So ko je nkan to dun gbo leti pe okay so ma pe okay ke la le se ta fi le ra won odo ilowo iyen ni lati fi eko fe tun ko won ki won le mo ki won de tun mo to re dada.
Mo ko computer nitori pe kin le ba je eyan ni ile aye ati kin le ba ran family mi lowo ati kin le ba ran awon ore mi lowo.
Mo ko bi won se nlo computer dini wi pe o je ipenija fun emi irobin lati wa ko computer nitori nti okunrin le se obirin na le se ju be lo idini ye ti mo fi nko computer.
If Akinwale can get help from Airtel, he's going to be able to touch more lives and empower more youths. With this kind of empowerment, he's going to encourage and help the community in terms of economy and give the youth purpose, something they can actually live for. Currently, it's limited. He needs a larger space to accommodate more computers and to handle more students and to be able to train more youths and empower them.
Say it's a valley, I know. You know me, I don't go. Tori, you know, ti ala ti mo ba le ri ero ayara bi asa to po ma le ko awon eniyan to po ma de le ni ori ofe lati tun de lati je ke mi gan o gba awon eniyan sise lati ma je ka jo sise so ma de ma ri owo lati ara be tori pe a tun ma lo awon ise yi lati sise a ma ro owo so a de ma tun je ke eko fe yen ko ma tesi waju so a na de ma.
With this help, it's not just going to empower Akinwale to help, but it's going to touch more lives in this community.
Nothing like a little selflessness, eh? What an inspiration. Touching lives. I'd like to welcome our guests, Adesina Zakios Akinwale, Akanji Dimeji, and Alabi Grace to the studio. Welcome to the studio. Thank you so much for coming on the program.
Yes, you're welcome.
And well done on such an amazing job. It's such a selfless thing to do. I mean, you could be earning money from teaching people how to use computers.
Yes, ma'am.
But why did you choose to do it for free?
As we know that the needs of computer literacy is essential in this century, but many did not have the privilege. Some may be social, economic status of the parents and others, but what I know is that people have the desire to know it. Some are having desire, but they are not ready to learn.
Yeah.
And some, they are ready to learn, but nobody to sponsor them. And the high rate of people having the desire and nobody to sponsor them is higher than the one that do not have the privilege. So I just think of doing this computer training so that people will be computer literate.
All right, you've talked about computer literacy, but what are the other needs of people in your community?
There are several needs of others, of people in my community. If I look around, we can see even presently the delinquent behavior of youth is growing daily. And if we talk about delinquent behavior, there are several factors that bring about this.
Okay.
It's not that they want to behave anyhow, but if you look at it very well, it may be from the parents, some even in schools and colleagues and all the like. But what brings about, well, the major challenge is that people, they are not embarking on their own business. And the Bible even makes us to know that when you are idle, devil can have that chance to do what he like and to make your life to be stranded and not to become what you want to become in life. So people have faced serious challenge. Some students are not able to school after their old level. They have nothing to do again, so they just keep on sitting down. So this be my concern, that what should I do so that people will be able to have the knowledge of computer.
Grace, I heard you in the video say that what a man can do, a woman can do better, which I agree with. But I want to ask you, what are you hoping to do with your computer training?
Mo ko computer ni ile-ise Winners Institute. Nitori ni aye ode oni. O ti di aye imo computer. Gbogbo eniyan lo si fe ko, lo fe ni imo nipa re. Idi niyan ti mo fi ko computer ni ile-ise Winners Computer Institute. Ale ti obirin ti okunrin le se. Obirin le se ju be lo. Ta ba bi apere ti a ba de ile iwe, ko si ibi ti won ti ma lo computer di ni ti mo fi ni pe ti okunrin le se obirin na le se ju be
Chris, you're a girl after my own heart. Dimeji, what are you hoping to do after you finish your computer training?
Nti mo ni lero lati se ni pe ki ni ba ran mi lowo ati awon re. Ki tun le ba ran awon to wa ni agbe ki ni ba ran won lowo.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate your coming here. You know, you are such an inspiration. You're not only selfless, but you're such an inspiration. And I can also see that you're a very big dreamer as well. And Airtel would like to support you in some way, all right? They'd like to touch your lives in some way so that you can continue helping more people and so that people like, you know, Grace and Dimeji can also help more people as well within your area, your local area and your community. So Airtel would like to donate to you 4 computers and a 5 kVA generator, 2 UPS surge, a modem, 1 colored printer, 1 black and white printer, 2 external drives, 2 card readers, a scanner, and 1 laminating machine. So tell us how you feel right now.
We didn't mean I'm happy. But it's not only when I show forth that I'm happy, but within me, I'm happy because I see it as a privilege and God bringing it that at a start, He wants to see how far I'm going to use it to even help others and to make my dreams come to pass. So I'm very grateful within me. So to testify before God and before men, I'm so much happy.
There's one more thing. So they're also going to give you a shop rental.
I'm happy.
Thank you so much for coming on the program. Really appreciate your being here. And we salute all the work that you're doing. And we hope that, you know, with the very little that we've been able to do to touch your lives, you'll be able to do so much more for others. All right. Akinwale isn't only an inspiration and a selfless person, but of course a dreamer. And we hope that Airtel has been able to make those dreams come alive. Life in rural communities is difficult, and most people struggle to earn a living and have a decent life. It is even more difficult for the aged to survive, especially if they're single and don't have support from their family. Mama Mercy is barren and has suffered most of her life as a result of rejection by her family and her community. She's struggling to look after herself and her sister's son that was left with her. Airtel went to see how we could touch their lives.
The most basic requirements of life are a place to sleep, food, and water. But food and water is often scarce in rural communities, making the youth and especially the elderly much more vulnerable. What can be done to help the elderly that are living in remote areas of Nigeria?
This community is located outside Port Harcourt City. And life here is very unbearable because much of the occupation of the people living here is farming. And the people who farm here just for the family, for livelihood. I don't live in this community anymore. I live outside here. So sometimes when I travel in here and I meet my grandmother's sister, she will be telling me all these stories, how she's being humiliated, intimidated, and sometimes beaten, her flute being taken, a woman that doesn't have anything. And when I got to know about this program, I then decided to nominate her so that she can have some help. She's alone, she's barren, she has humiliations and intimidations.
Dabe kara mesi bia bia mba be me bo no wa abiru be go sum be ba be be ani ba gbinwi kon ele wi nu ele wi alu ga bia woni tan ga ke ba dam
Knowing our tradition, if you have not married, you give birth. When you get married, you don't go with the baby to your husband's home. So the boy is with his adopted child.
Dabe kara no nobody Sunday. Da kado da dekmeni. Ne ne amen da ka la lubo. Sumbe lumi don da ka bimne bi talking. La no andele kmeni gaye jiriba ne. Elo akato wa.
So nung ere wenya wenya ken. Nube ko winda ka me. Aki wa bedam. Asu wenya ke me bieba.
The boy was not able to finish his secondary school because of lack of money. She's a subsistence farmer and even doesn't have the farm to farm. If you look at the house she's living, the house is falling, has fallen. It's collapsing. Some of the food she planted as a garden, sometime when she comes back, the other side have taken it. And when she asks of it, she might be humiliated or be intimidated or be beaten sometime.
Ko wani ko me kan deni ya aba mo ga bi ga do me wi ya kan na ere gidi ba e to pa ga si ni si na di so si ni ere ta inu me bo be ba be yiri ba ni sa si nto pa ere si npi ni ga da ere kan di ga ye si to ti to no na e wi ya na ere ti ni gidi ba da ni ere ba gidi ba ni te yin ko ipa do na di.
This old woman with this little boy who was not able to finish his secondary school because of lack of funds, she doesn't have money to train him, and herself doesn't have any farm to farm. She doesn't have food to eat. So life becomes so very unbearable for them. So they really need help to have a shelter where she can live, and the boy who has a brighter future, but there's lack of funds to train him so that in turn he will look after this woman. So I think she needs help so that she can cope up with life.
I'm going to call her. 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 I'm going to call her.
Wow, it's one thing to experience such hardship, but to be ostracized by your family and community is something no one ever prays or hopes for. Join me as I welcome to the studio Mama Mercy and her two grandnephews. Welcome to the program. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you very much.
Mama, I want to just ask you, how does it feel to be outcast by your family, where you don't have any family anymore? So Sunday, I want to ask you, if you had the opportunity to do something for Mama, what would you do for her?
So ndame lelo, we didn't talk about it yet, Muna. So ndame lelo, so ndamu madenu, nyerebane, mare alo, because tunsi be ereta enu, tunsi be reti gun dedo, pepe iwe ba muranage, ne so me elaji nuaya luntele biye nyerebane.
James, I know that you nominated them as well. And you've watched her go through so much. What is it like watching someone who's this old, you know, going through that much and people beating her, saying really, really horrible and, you know, demeaning things to her? What is it like just seeing that happen?
Actually, I grew up to see her as my grandmother. That is her, because my own great grandmother, I do not see her. So she's taken as my grandmother, mostly because she doesn't have any son.
Yeah.
I am very close to her,
okay.
Very close. So she will be telling me all these horrible news and I will not feel good about it. I used to feel that if this woman has a son or a daughter,
yeah.
I think people will have not taken her to that extent. That even some pawpaw trees, they will plug it. She's the one who planted it. They will plug it, and when she will ask, they will tell her where is her portion in this home. And I sometimes grieved at it.
Thank you so much for talking to us, sharing with us.
Thank you.
I think you're a very strong woman, and you don't deserve any of the humiliation or suffering. Because, I mean, just look at the two boys next to you shows that you are a mother to so many.
She's thanking you.
All right. It's not going to stop there because Airtel wants to support you and touch your life. Just make life easier for you. All right? So what we are going to do, Airtel is going to construct one-bedroom bungalow apartment for you. And they will be giving you 60 plastic chairs and 10 plastic tables.
Thank you. Mango, yeah. Mango, but the air do it, yeah. A god, I do it, yeah. A banner and senior. If I quite only, when you know you eh, Mendo, why, yeah. A banner about calling, call young, and we don't do anything. Mendo, why, yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. You're welcome. We're also going to give you two small canopies. How does she feel?
Oh, Abiyadwa, so... Abiyadwa, lo?
Nyemi, eh. It's about quite do me, nyemi, eh.
Okay. She's very, very glad. She's very happy. She said, doesn't know that in her life, this kind of a thing will happen to her. That she's very, very excited. As you guys can hear her, she she's saying thank you.
Thank you so much for coming on the program. Really appreciate your being here.
Thank you very
much. Thank you.
Thank you for joining Airtel Touching Lives. Be sure to join us again as we celebrate people that are making a difference right here in Nigeria.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm gonna shine my light. I'm gonna make a difference. Touch your life, be the change. Shine my light and make a difference. You're the one to make the world a much better place. You're the one, touching lives. Touch your life, I wanna be the change. I'm gonna shine my light, I'm gonna make a difference. Touch your life, be the change. Shine my light and make a difference. You're the one to make the world a much better place.
Hello, Nigeria, and welcome to Airtel Touching Lives, the show that celebrates and assists the individuals and projects that are making a difference to the lives of people around them. My name is Wanawana, and just like Airtel, I have a passion to make a difference and transform lives. I invite you to join us on an emotional journey as we witness some incredibly touching moments. We take you across the country, meeting individuals, families, and communities who are going that extra mile to achieve something for everyone. They're trying to make life better, not just for themselves, but for others around them. Coming up in this episode, we visit a unique computer school that provides free training for youth from disadvantaged backgrounds. And we meet an elderly woman that has been marginalized all of her life because she's barren and unable to bear children. Computer training is a good way to open many doors in life. However, the problem is that most people who could benefit from it cannot afford to pay for it. And that's where Akinwale Adesina comes in and trains youth that are most in need for free. Airtel went to see how we could help him touch more lives.
The computer school is situated on a busy national road. Many people drive through town, but few stop and contribute to local businesses. There is a lot of unemployment, especially amongst the youth. And the town is in need of development. But despite these challenges, some are making a positive change.
4 years ago, I was able to meet Akinwale in a particular computer training that was organized. I nominated Akinwale because he was willing to learn, and it was his first time of actually learning computer, how to use computer. So the trainers were happy to have him around because he's always willing to learn. He's gentle, he's nice, he's kind. He's always willing to help others. Akinwale is one of the hardworking young men that is actually available in this town. Akinwale has chosen to train others in that particular area. It's going to empower youth in this community, and it's going to enhance the economy of this community.
Inu mi man dun lati ko awon omo kekere odun mo mo ni inu didun lati ko awon agbalagba na lati bi le se opolopo nkan ori siri si idea lo wa sugbon nigba
make those dreams come alive. Life in rural communities is difficult, and most people struggle to earn a living and have a decent life. It is even more difficult for the aged to survive, especially if they're single and don't have support from their family. Mama Mercy is barren and has suffered most of her life as a result of rejection by her family and her community. She's struggling to look after herself and her sister's son that was left with her. Airtel went to see how we could touch their lives.
The most basic requirements of life are a place to sleep, food, and water. But food and water is often scarce in rural communities, making the youth and especially the elderly much more vulnerable. What can be done to help the elderly that are living in remote areas of Nigeria?
This community is located outside Port Harcourt City. And life here is very unbearable because much of the occupation of the people living here is farming. And the people who farm here just for the family, for livelihood. I don't live in this community anymore. I live outside here. So sometimes when I travel in here and I meet my grandmother's sister, she will be telling me all these stories, how she's being intimidated and sometimes beaten, her fruit being taken, a woman that doesn't have anything. And when I got to know about this program, I then decided to nominate her so that she can have some help. She's alone, she's barren, she has humiliations and intimidations.
Dabe kala Messi, bia bia. Mba be me bon no wa. Abi ru be go sum be be. Be be bu ani va gbinwi. Kon ele wi nu ele wi. Alu ga bia bu ni tan ga. Ke ba dam. Mbe a pe I do na wa go nu ele wi.
No in our tradition, if you have not married, you give birth. When you get married, you don't go with the baby to your husband's home. So the boy is with her adopted child.
Da be kara no nobody Sunday. Da kado da dekmeni. Ne ne amenda ka la lubo. Sumbe lo mi don da ka bim ne vet okin. La no andele kme ga yiri ba ne. Elo akato wa.
So nung ere wiya wiya ke. Nube ko winda ka me. Aki wa bedam. As we are maybe ever, we are going to be a supper, going to tangan.
The boy was not able to finish his secondary school because of lack of money. She's a subsistence farmer and even doesn't have the farm to farm. If you look at the house she's living, the house is falling, has fallen, it's collapsing. Some of the food she planted as a garden, sometimes when she comes back, the other side have taken it. And when she asks of it, she might be humiliated or be intimidated or be beaten sometime.
Ko wa ni ko me kan din ya aba mo ga bi ga do me wi ya ke na ere gidi ba e to pa ga si ni si na di so si ni ere tai nu me bo ba be yiri ba ni sa si n to pa ere si n pi ni ga da ere ke di ga ye si to ti n to no na I mo yin na ere ti ni gidi ba da mi ba yiri ba ni.
This old woman with this little boy who was not able to finish his secondary school because of lack of funds, she doesn't have money to train him and herself doesn't have any farm to farm. She doesn't have food to eat. So life becomes so very unbearable for them. So they really need help to have a shelter where she can live, and the boy who has a brighter future, but there's lack of funds to train him so that in turn, he will look after this woman. So I think she needs help so that she can cope up with life.
I'm going to call her. 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 I'm going to call her.
I'm going to talk to you. I'm going to go to the house.
Wow, it's one thing to experience such hardship, but to be ostracized by your family and community is something no one ever prays or hopes for. Join me as I welcome to the studio Mama Mercy and her two grandnephews. Welcome to the program. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you very much.
Mama, I want to just ask you, how does it feel to be outcast by your family, where you don't have any family anymore?
Ana nyame. Ana le no. And I don't me, eh?
So Sunday, I want to ask you, if you had the opportunity to do something for Mama, what will you do for her?
So Ndame Lelo, we didn't have to pay a Muna. So Ndame Lelo, so Ndamu Madenu. Nyeribayene, Mare Alo. Because since we are tired, since we are taking the door, Pepe, we are going to be able to do it. We are going to
James, I know that you nominated them as well, and you've watched her go through so much. What is it like watching someone who's this old, you know, going through that much and people beating her, saying really, really horrible and, you know, demeaning things to her? What is it like just seeing that happen?
Actually, I grew up to see her as my grandmother. That is her, because my own great grandmother, I do not see her. So she's taken as my grandmother mostly because she doesn't have any son.
Yeah.
I am very close to her.
Okay.
Very close. So she will be telling me all these horrible news and I will not feel good about it. I used to feel that if this woman has a son or a daughter,
yeah,
I think people will have not taken her to that extent. That even some pawpaw trees, they will plug it. She's the one who planted it. They will plug it, and when she will ask, they will tell her where is her portion in this home. And I sometimes grieved at it.
Thank you so much for talking to us, sharing with us.
Thank you.
I think you're a very strong woman, and you don't deserve any of the humiliation or suffering. Because, I mean, just look at the two boys next to you shows that you are a mother to so many.
She's thanking you.
All right.
Tell me, you're not funny at your affair. Where are you going to call? You're not going to be here. You're not going to be here. So, you know, I'm going to be here. I'm going to be here. Tony, if I need you, that's a man. I'm going to be here. I'm going to be here. So, you know, I'm going to be here. 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 I'm going to be here.
There's always need for computer literacy. Computers are everywhere, and we use it in everyday activity. Without adequate computer literacy, kids and young minds and youth can actually get any job.
Banking work, even in church, every places. So computer is being useful. But money is we are mobile share jam loan you, mobile share CBT you, is the computer. So get be your door. So go jam can told you but let it be okay. So we okay, can I let you have a round day logo in any lati fear coffee to come and can only more order to my another.
Mo ko computer nitori pe kin le ba je eyan ni ile aye ati kin le ba ran family mi lowo ati kin le ba ran awon ore mi lowo.
Mo ko bi won se nlo computer dini wi pe o je ipenija fun emi irobin lati wa ko computer nitori nti okunrin le se obirin na le se ju be lo idi niyan ti mo fi ko computer.
If Akinwale can get help from Airtel, is going to be able to touch more lives and empower more youths. With this kind of empowerment, it's going to encourage and help the community in terms of economy and give the youths purpose, something they can actually live for. Currently, it's limited. It needs a larger space to accommodate more computers and to handle more students and to be able to train more youths and empower them.
Tori iran ati ala ti mo ba le ri ero ayara bi asa to po ma le ko awon eniyan to po ma de le ni ori ofe lati tun la je ke mi gan o gba awon eniyan sise lati ma je ka jo sise so ma de ma ri owo lati ara be tori pe a tun ma lu awon ise yi lati sise a ma ro owo so a de ma tun je ke eko fe yen ko ma tesi waju so a na de ma.
With this help, it's not just going to empower Akinwale to help, but it's going to touch more lives in this community.
Nothing like a little selflessness, eh? What an inspiration. Touching lives. I'd like to welcome our guest, Adesina Zakios Akinwale.
Akonji Dimeji and Alabi Grace to the studio. Welcome to the studio. Thank you so much for coming on the program.
Yes, you're welcome.
And well done on such an amazing job. It's such a selfless thing to do. I mean, you could be earning money from teaching people how to use computers.
Yes, ma'am.
But why did you choose to do it for free?
As we know that the needs of computer literacy is essential in this century, but many did not have the privilege. Some may be social, economic status of the parents and others, but what I know is that people have the desire to know it. Some are having desire, but they are not ready to learn.
Yeah.
And some, they are ready to learn, but nobody to sponsor them. And the high rate of people having the desire and nobody to sponsor them is higher than the one that do not have the privilege. So I just think of doing this computer training so that people will be computer literate.
All right, you've talked about computer literacy, but what are the other needs of people in your community?
There are several needs of others, of people in my community. If I look around, we can see even presently the delinquent behavior of youth is growing daily. And if we talk about delinquent behavior, there are several factors that bring about this.
Okay.
It's not that they want to behave anyhow, but if you look at it very well, maybe from the parents, some even in schools and colleagues and all the like. But what bring about, the major challenge is that people, they are not embarking on their own business. And the Bible even makes us to know that when you are idle, devil can have that chance to do what he like and to make your life to be stranded and not to become what you want to become in life. So people have faced serious challenge. Some students are not able to school after their old level, they have nothing to do again. So they just keep on sitting down. So this be my concern, that what should I do so that people will be able to have the knowledge of computer.
Grace, I heard you in the video say that what a man can do, a woman can do better, which I agree with. But I want to ask you, what are you hoping to do with your computer training?
I'm going to computer in the Winners Institute. I'm going to go to the computer. I'm going computer. I'm going to go to the computer. I'm going to go to the computer in the Winners Computer Institute. And then see obirin ti okunrin le se obirin le se ju be lo ta ba bi apere ti a ba de ilewe ko si ibi ti won ti ma lo computer di ni ti mo fi ni pe ti okunrin le se obirin na le se ju be lo.
Grace, you're a girl after my own heart. Dimeji, what are you hoping to do after you finish your computer training?
Nti mo ni lero lati se ni pe ki ni ba ran mi lowo ati awon re kin tun le ba ran awon to wa ni agbe kin le ba ran won lowo.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate your coming here. You know, you are such an inspiration. You're not only selfless, but you're such an inspiration. And I can also see that you're a very big dreamer as well. And Airtel would like to support you in some way, all right? They'd like to touch your lives in some way so that you can continue helping more people. And so that people like, you know, Grace and Dimeji can also help more people as well within your area, your local area and your community. So Airtel would like to donate to you 4 computers and a 5 kVA generator, 2 UPS surge, a modem, one colored printer, one black and white printer, 2 external drives, 2 card readers, a scanner, and 1 laminating machine. So tell us how you feel right now.
Within me, I'm happy. But it's not only when I show forth that I'm happy, but within me, I'm happy because I see it as a privilege and God bringing it, that at a start, He wants to see how far I'm going to use it to even help others and to make my dreams come to pass. So I'm very grateful within me. So to testify before God and before men, I'm so much happy.
There's one more thing. So they're also going to give you a shop rental.
I'm happy.
Thank you so much for coming on the program. Really appreciate your being here. And we salute all the work that you're doing. And we hope that, you know, with the very little that we've been able to do to touch your lives,
you'll be able to do so much more for others. All right, Akinwale isn't only an inspiration and a selfless person, but of course a dreamer. And we hope that Airtel has been able to